My original greenhouse was made with PVC. I had an aphid infestation that I could not stop. I decided to solarize it and bake the aphids. Although this worked well, I melted my PVC pipes. In cold weather, I was losing a lot of heat from the single layer plastic cover. With the new build, I made it shorter and insulated with our 10 polystyrene board. I decided to build with wood, so all of the wood surfaces are covered with deck sealer, for moisture protection, and appearance. I recut and stained the rafters in the shop. I used bracing and clamps to line everything up as I go. I thought I could offset the back rafters from the front, but changed my mind and corrected them mid-course. In doing this, the foam board seams don't line up with a rafter.
Okay, I've got blocker board, and I've cut that, I've measured it at the bottom and the top. So I'm going to put in these 3 1/8 inch cabinet screws. These work nice. Okay, I secured the top first, then I come down to the bottom with the blocker board for spacing. And then we put this screw in, which will help tighten that up, because this board is a little bit flexible and it will pull in. Okay, sometimes measurements don't work out exactly right, so it's looking good down there, but this one's a little long, so I'm just gonna shave off a little bit and get it to the right length.
The best way to install the polycarbonate is bottom row first, then the second row, then the top. Add the channels as you go. It's impossible to slide a sheet in from the top down to the bottom. This polycarbonate channel was very difficult to get the sheets into.
Tighten it up. Put a screw down here and on top down here as well. This tape drains the condensation out of the channel inside the polycarbonate.
With the rafters realigned, I added steel to the ridge beam.
So, putting this flashing in here to keep the critters from burrowing under the wood. So then I'll bury it under the ground. So you take the whole sheet, stick it on here. It goes down to here, we'll piece that part in. So what I did on both sides, I take this and stick it up through there, the whole sheet, and then draw a line where it needs to be. Cut it off with a handsaw, and it's all lining up pretty good. This up there, clamped on. I got that one, marked it there. Marked up the spray foam inside. Spray foam this little gap up here. But the way this is gonna work, this plastic's going down in that groove with a wiggle wire. Fit that right in there. So we got all the pieces in the wall, just got to build doors now. Okay, so what I did here is taped them together, top and bottom, all three sheets, so that I could slide them around and push them up to the top. I put blockers into the temporary blocks to hold it in place. Now I'm going to screw this first sheet, take this sheet off and move it over, put in the glue, and then put it back and start attaching it. Also made marks where to put the screws. Got a ladder up there. It's kind of soft, so I steadied it with a 2x4. But here, you put in a little dab will do you. Probably that's more than enough glue. There we go. Now that's snug.
At some point I'll use this RV roof coat on the polystyrene.
Okay, so I'm putting screws in along the way. And taping with the greenhouse tape, hoping that'll seal out the insects. The flashing will take care of the leak, keep out the water. Okay, we got another piece on there. And just folded that up, attached it, used lots of silicone, taped it across there, hoping for the best. Now we have to tape this down, keep the bees out of there. Right. The old greenhouse coming into the new. Got my cucumber plants, tomato plants. On the left you see the ginger plants. And of course the mango tree in the middle. It's about 80 degrees in here.